What happens when teachers design projects that empower students with voice and choice? Students embrace a maker mindset. They define themselves as inventors and creators. They learn to take creative risks. Here they experiment and engage in iterative thinking. And when this happens, they embrace a growth mindset and grow resilient. They become problem solvers and systems thinkers. They become divergent thinkers, thinking outside the box. They use creative constraint to find original uses for materials. Here they discover it's okay to be different. Often students embrace curiosity and wonder. They become explorers, seeking out new information and thinking critically. They grow more empathetic as they design meaningful products that they launch to the world. On an academic level, students are more engaged and the information sticks. Often there's an increase in student achievement. Meanwhile, they learn key skills like project management, collaboration, and communication. True, these skills will prepare students for the creative economy, but more importantly, they empower students for a creative life. Here they see that making is magic. We know that there is a time crunch in schools, and materials can be scarce. Sometimes you're stuck with a tight curriculum map. But when you, as a teacher, empower your students with voice and choice, they become the makers who change the world. But how do we make the most out of project-based learning when we have tight time deadlines, a set of standards to teach, and limited resources? Well, one solution is to combine project-based learning with design thinking. You can think of PBL as a pedagogical framework and design thinking as a creative framework. When this happens, you end up with PBL by design. Now, design thinking is a human-centered approach to creative problem solving. It's used in the arts, in engineering, in the corporate world, and in social and civic spaces. While there are many design thinking models, the launch cycle is a student-centered framework that you can use in any subject with any grade level. Here's how it works. It starts with look, listen, and learn. The goal here is awareness. It might be a sense of wonder over a process, an understanding of a problem, an observation of a natural phenomenon, or an awareness of a social issue. But it also includes empathy with the community. And then, sparked by curiosity, students move to the second phase, where they ask tons of questions, which leads to understanding the process or problem through an authentic research experience. They might do needs assessments, conduct surveys, watch videos, listen to podcasts, conduct experiments, make observations, analyze data, do a video chat with an expert, or engage in online research. Students then apply the newly acquired knowledge to potential solutions. In this phase, they navigate ideas. Here, they not only brainstorm, but they also analyze ideas, combine ideas, and generate a concept for what they will create. From there, they create a prototype, whether that prototype is a digital work, a physical product, a service, a system, or an event. Next, they highlight what's working and fix what's failing. Here they view the revision process as an experiment full of iterations, where every mistake takes them closer and closer to success. And then when it's done, it's ready to launch to an audience. In the launch phase, they send their work to the world. And then based on the audience feedback, they move into a new iteration, where they're able to look, listen, and learn all over again. When you combine design thinking and project-based learning, students engage in authentic projects that lead to deeper learning.